السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In our previous hadith learning series, we discussed some hadiths under the bab, under Kitab al-Ilm in Sahih al-Bukhari. No. Under the same bab, Kitab al-Ilm, bab qawli Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma allimhu al-kitab. The statement of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, aloud, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma, wa Allah, allimhu al-kitab, allimhu al-kitab, bestow him. It is Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. The knowledge of the book. Allah, teach him. Oh Allah, teach him the knowledge of the kitab. The kitab. The book. Which is the book?
Al-Quran.
Al-Quran. So, Prophet's prayer or Prophet's dua. It is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's dua to Allah. In favor of Ibn Abbas ayyallahu anhu. That hadith. حدثنا أبو معمر قال حدثنا عبد الوارث قال حدثنا خالد عن إكرمة عن ابن عباس قال ضمني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال اللهم علم في الكتاب. Narrated ابن عباس رضي الله عنه. Once Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم embraced me. Embraced me. لما means to? Yes. Embrace. Embraced. Alinganjiz. To embrace. Embraced. لما means? Embraced. Say aloud.
Embraced.
Lammani. He embraced me. Who? Prophet?
Muhammad
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam embraced me. وقاله, then he said, and he said, Allahumma alim bil kitab, O Allah, bestow on him the knowledge of the book. That is Al-Quran, the knowledge of Quran. So, you know, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu is one of the major mufassirin, the interpreters of Quran. Major mufassirin of Quran. So, Ibn Abbas got so much wide knowledge about the Quran. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed for him to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Then, next bab. باب متى يصبح السماء صغير. This. Then also, and Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه قال أقبلت راكبا عن على حمار أطان وأنا يومئذ قد ناهزت الاحتلام ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي بمنى إلى غير جدار فمررت بين يدي بعض الصف وأرسلت الأطان ترتع فدخلت في الصف فلم ينكر ذلك علي. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu narrates, قال, he says, أقبلت راكبا على حمار أطان. It is, once I came riding as on a she-camel. She-camel, you know, حمار أطان, she-camel. That is, female, female camel. She-camel, female camel. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu was riding upon a, riding on a she-camel. Then, وأنا يومئذ قد ناهزت الاحتلام. And at that time I was I had just attained puberty. Puberty. This I had attained takleef. Bulugh. Not takleef. Bulugh. Okay. Bulugh. Puberty. Just puberty attained. He had attained puberty just then. Okay. At the age of puberty, attained the age of puberty. So, soon after that, this incident. For Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yusalli bi mina ila ghayri jidar. And the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was performing, offering namaz, offering salah, prayers in Mina. Okay, offering prayers in Mina. And Ibn Abbas was riding on a camel. Okay, coming near to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at that time, in the Mina, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was performing prayers or salah bi ghairi jidar, ila ghairi jidar, ghairi jidar. That is without a jidar means wall. Jidar means
wall.
Without a, without any obstacle, without any objects before him. That is without a jidar. That is in an open space. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers were performing salah in an open space in the Mina. فَمَرَرْتُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ بَعْضِ الصَّفْ. And at that time, I passed in front of some of the rows, some of the saf, in between the saf. That is, in front of some of the saf lines. Then, وَأَرْسَلْتُ الْأَتَانَ التَّرْتَعُ. And I released the she camel for grazing. Racing in the field. Okay. Tirtav. Atan. Fadakhaltu fi saf. And then I entered into the line. Into one of the safs. To perform salah. Falam yungar dhalika alayhi. And at that time, nobody objected it. So this happened when Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu was a young boy. He had attained puberty, but it was soon after that, or he had just attained puberty then. Okay. Now, next hadith under the same bar. That is, and Mahmud ibn Rabi'a qala aqaltu min an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam majjatan majjaha fi وجهي وانا ابن خمس سنين من ذل. Narrated Mahmud ibn Rabi'a radiyallahu anhu. When I was a boy of 5, ibn khams sinin means a boy of 5, yes, allowed frame is there, say allowed. Then when I was a boy of 5, it is when I was just 5 years old, I remember that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took water from a bucket. Dalu means dalwin,
bucket.
Then what did Prophet do? He took water from the bucket into his mouth and he threw it on my face. Okay, threw it on the face of this small boy. Who was that boy? Mahmud ibn Rabi'ah. He recalls this incident when he grew up. The incident took place when he was just a boy of 5 years. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to play with small children. Okay, he was just playing with the small children. So Prophet used to play with the small children. That we can understand from this hadith. Okay. Now next bab. Next bab. Chapter 2. Go out in search of knowledge. مطلب طلب العلم خروج الخروج لطلب العلم. That is going out, going to far away places in search of knowledge. The importance of, okay, to go out in search of knowledge. Okay. ورحل جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه مسيرة شهر إلى عبد الله بن أنيس في حديث واحد. So to get one hadith Jabir bin Abdullah radiyallahu anhu traveled journey of a month to Abdullah ibn Unais to get one hadith. So there the importance of seeking true knowledge, seeking knowledge is mentioned here. Okay, then under the that bab, one hadith is mentioned. That hadith actually we have passed in another bab in hadith learning series 33. That hadith is about Prophet Musa alayhi salam and his sahib, that is Khadr alayhi salam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam, Prophet Musa alayhi salam traveled in search of knowledge, in search of Khadr alayhi salam, whom Allah had bestowed with special knowledge. So to have some experience with Khadr alayhi salam, Prophet Musa alayhi salam traveled to see him. Okay, to see whom? See Khadr alayhi salam. That hadith we have discussed earlier in another bab in the same Kitab al-Ilm. Okay, here also the same hadith is there, but the Ravis are a little bit different. From Ibn the immediate narrator is Ibn Abbas. Okay. But other Ravi, the chain, is a little bit different. And the words are also a little bit different, but actually the same idea is contained in both the hadiths. So what you said, that hadith, that is, this hadith, the earlier part we shall discuss first. Narrated Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, annahu tamara huwa wahil hurr bin Qais bin Hisr al-Fazari fi sahib Musa alayhi salam. That is, Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu and his companion and his friend Hurr bin Qais bin Hisr al-Fazari radiyallahu anhu differed in the matter of sahib Musa. Who was sahib Musa? Who was Sahib Musa? That is, Sufi, فَمَرَّ بِهِمَا Ubay ibn Ka'b. Then there passed Ubay ibn Ka'b, another Sahabi. Okay. فَدَعَاهُ ibn Abbas, and Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu called him. That is, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu called whom? Ubay ibn Ka'b. Ibn Abbas and Hurr ibn Qais were discussing the matter. That is, who was Sahib Musa? And they differed in their opinions. So at that time, Ubay ibn Ka'b was passing by. Then Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu invited him to the talk. Then فقال, then Ibn Abbas said to Ubay ibn Ka'b, إِنِّي تَمَارَيْتُ أَنَا وَصَاحِبِي هَذَا فِي صَاحِبْ مُوسَى الَّذِي سَعَلَى السَّبِيلَ إِلَىٰ لُقِّجِهِ. So we are discussing this matter. That is, we are differing. I and my friend Hurr ibn Qais differ in this matter. That is, who Sahib Musa was. الَّذِي سَعَلَى السَّبِيلَ إِلَىٰ لُقِيِّهِ. Whom Moses, Musa alayhi salam, asked the way to meet to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَمَرَّ بِهِمَا آذَن. هَلْ سَمِعْتَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ سَلَامِ يَذُكُرُ شَأْنَهُ. Have you heard anything about this Sahib Musa from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Say. فقال, then Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu anhu said, نعم, yes, I have heard something from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about Sahib Musa alayhi salam. Then he said, بينما موسى, yes,
Aloud. Bainama Musa fi malay min bani Israel.
Aloud, still aloud.
Da'u rajul. Fakala hal ta'alama adhan alam min. Kala Musa. La. Fawha Allahu ila Musa.
Fawha Allahu ila Musa. بلى عبدنا خلق.
فسأل موسى السبيل فسأل موسى السبيل فوجب
سبيل إليه
سبيل إليه
فجعل الله له
فجعل الله له الحوت آية فقيل إذا فقدت الحوت فرجي فإنك ستلقاه وكان يتبي أسر الحوت في البحر
وقال الحوت في البحر
وقال لموسى فتاه أرأيت إذا أوينا إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت حوت وما أنساني إلا الشيطان أن أذكره قال ذلك ما كنا نبغ فارتدى على آثارهما قصصا فوجد
خضرا
فوجد خضرا
فكان من شأنها
الذي
قص الله عز وجل في كتابه. So the same hadith is there. Here also. Some words are different, a little bit. Here the hadith is like this. إذ جاءه then بينما موسى في ملئ من بني إسرائيل إذ جاءه رجل فقال أتعلم أحدا أعلم منك قال موسى لا فأوحى الله عز وجل إلى موسى بلى عبدنا خضر فسأل السبيل إلى لقيه فجعل الله له الحوت آية وقيل له إذا فقدت الحوت فارجع فإنك ستلقاه فقال موسى صلى الله عليه وسلم يتبع أثر الحوت في البحر فقال فتى موسى لموسى أرأيت إذا بينا إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت وما أنسانه إلا الشيطان أن أذكره قال موسى ذلك ما كنا نبغي فارتد على آثارهما قصصا فوجدا خضرا فكان من شأنهما ما قص الله في كتابه. So here the story is mentioned. The details of the story mentioned in the verses 60-82 of Surah Al-Kahf of Al-Quran. The meaning of the hadith allowed.
While Moses sitting in the company of some Israelites, a man came and asked him, Do you know anyone who is more learned than you? Moses replied, No. So Allah sent divine inspiration to Moses. Our slave Khalil.
Bala abduna Khalil. Is more learned than you. Then Musa alayhi salam asked Allah, how to meet him.
How to meet Khalil
alayhi salam. So Allah made
the
fish as a sign for him. And he was told that when the fish was lost, he should
return. That is when the fish was lost
to the place where he had lost the fish, and there he would meet Al Khadir. So Moses went looking for the sign of the fish in the sea. The servant boy of Moses said to him,
Do you remember when we betook ourselves to the rock?
I indeed forgot the fish. None but Satan made me forget to remember it. On that Musa alayhi salam said,
That is what we are seeking for.
Yes, we have been seeking. So they went back retracing their footsteps and found Khalil alayhi salam. And what happened further to them is narrated in the Holy Quran. It is in Surah Al-Kahf. Surah Al-Kahf, verses 60-82. To read, recite.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قال موسى لفتاه لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبا فلما بلغا مجمع بينهما نسيا حوتهما فاتخذ سبيله في البحر سربا فلما جاوزا قال لفتاه وادنا ودانا لقد لقينا من سفرنا هذا نسبا قال أرأيت إذ أبينا إلى الصخرة فإني نسيت الحوت وما أنساني إلا الشيطان أن أذكره فاتخذ سبيلته في البحر عجبا قال ذلك ما كنا نبغ فارتدا على آثارهما قصصا فوجدا عبدا من عبادنا آتيناه رحمة من عندنا وعلمناه من لدنا علما قال له موسى هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا فكيف تصبر على ما لم تحط به خبرا قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أسأل لك أمرا قال فإن اتبعتني فلا تسألني عن شيء حتى أحدث لك منه ذكرا فانطلقا حتى إذا ركبا في السفينة خرقها قال أخرقتها
لتغرق أهلها لقد جئت شيئا إمرا
قال ألم أقل إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت ولا ترهقني من أمري يسرا
فانطلقا حتى إذا لقيا غلاما فقتله
قال أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس
قال أقتلت نفسا زكية بغير نفس
لقد جئت شيئا نكرا قال ألم أقل لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا قال إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها
فلا تصاحبني قد بلغت من لدني عذرا
فانطلقا حتى إذا أتيا أهل قرية استطعما
أهلها فأبوا أن يضيفوهما فوجدا فيها جدارا يريد أن ينقض فأقامه
قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا
قال هذا فراق بيني وبينك
سأنبئك بتأويل ما لم تستطيع عليه صبرا
أما السفينة فكانت لمساكين يعملون
في البحر فأردت
وأن نغيبها وكان وراءهم ملك يأكل كل سفينة غصبا
وأما الغلام فكان أبواه مؤمنين فخشينا أن يرهقهما طغيانا وكفرا فأردنا أن يبدلهما ربهما خيرا منه زكاة وأقرب رحما
وأما الجدار فكان لغلامين يتيمين في المدينة وكان تحته تمر لهما وكان أبوهما صالحا
فأراد ربك
أن يبلغا أشدهما ويستخرجا كنزهما
رحمة من ربك
وما فعلته عن أمري ذلك تأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا. So verses 60 to 82 of Surah Al-Kahf. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وإذ قال موسى لفتاه لا أبرح حتى أبلغ مجمع البحرين أو أمضي حقبة. Behold, listen. Moses said to his attendant, his boy, I will not give up. I will not abandon this journey until I reach the junction of the two seas, where I spent and years in travel. So they were traveling to see who?
Khidr
alayhi salam. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَا مَجْمَعَ بَيْنِهِمَا نَسِيَا حُوتَهُمَا فَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ صَرَبًا. But when they reached the junction, مَجْمَعَ بَيْنِهِمَا, they forgot. نَسِيَا means? نَسِيَا
forgot.
Forgot about their fish. So this fish was made as an ayat by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This, they had to travel a lot. Then the fish, Allah made the fish as a symbol for them, as an ayat for them. When the fish was lost, when the fish will be lost, they had to travel back. And they will see that person. It is Khidr alayhi salam. That was Allah's command. But when they reached the junction of the two seas, or the Nasiyahutahuma, both of them, Musa alayhi salam and his attendant, both of them, they forgot the Hut. Hut means? Forgot what?
Fish.
Yes. Yes.
Fish.
Forgot the fish. فَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ سَرَبَا. And that fish took its course through the sea, straight as in a tunnel. Okay. The next. فَلَمَّا جَاوَزَا قَالَ لِفَتَاهُ آتِنَا غَدَاءَنَا لَقْدْ لَقِينَا مِنْ سَفَرِنَا هَذَا نَصْوَبَا. When they had passed on some distance, Musa alayhi salam, Prophet Musa alayhi salam said to his attendant, bring us our early meal. Truly we have suffered much fatigue, much tiredness at this stage of our travel or journey. Okay. Then قَالَ أَرَأَيْتَ إِذْ أَوَيْنَا إِلَى الصَّخْرَةِ فَإِنِّي نَسِيتُ الْحُوتَ فما أنسانه إلا الشيطان أن نذكره واتخذ سبيله في البحر عجبا. He replied, that is the attendant boy, the attendant of Musa alayhi salam, he replied, so you didn't you see, أرأيت إذ أوينا إلى الصخرة, when we took ourselves to the rock. صخرة means the
rock,
الصخرة, the rock. Then we indeed forget about the rock, about the fish. فَإِنِّي نَسِيتُ الْحُوتَ, suddenly I forgot about the fish, the matter of fish. Then وَمَا أَنْسَانِهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ أَنْ أَذْكُرَ, none but shaitan or satan made me forget to tell you about the lost sin of this fish, the matter of this fish. Then واتخذ سبيله في البحر عجبا, it took its course through the sea in a marvelous, in a surprising way. قال ذلك ما كنا نبغ فارتدى على آثارهما قصصا. Then Musa alayhi salam said, that was what we were seeking after. This point we are seeking. When we lost the fish, we have to return. Okay. Then we will see Khidr alayhi salam. So What did they do? فَرْتَدَّ عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمَا قَصَصًا. So they went back on their footsteps, following the paths they had come. They returned to see whom? To see? Khadir alayhi salam. Then, فَوَجَدَا عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّ عِلْمًا. So they found one of our servants, عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا. Quran mentions only this much. عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا. One of our servants. One of our dear servants. One of our servants. Who this servant was? Who Musa alayhi salam went to see? Who this servant was? Abdul. His name was? His name was? Yes, sir. Yes. Khadir alayhi salam. Tell out. Khadir alayhi salam. That is mentioned in the hadith. That hadith we discussed already. Okay. His name is mentioned as Khadir alayhi salam in Sahih hadith. Okay. Then. وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّ عِلْمًا أَتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا. And upon that servant, we have bestowed our grace, our blessings. And وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّ عِلْمًا. And we have taught knowledge from our own presence. We have taught Khadr alayhi salam knowledge from our own presence. Then. قال له موسى هل اتبعك على ان تعلمني مما علمت رشدا. موسى عليه السلام said to this person, that is خضر عليه السلام, may I follow thee, may I follow you on the footing that you teach me, on condition that you teach me something of the higher truth which you have been taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Accept me as a student. Will you accept me as a student? Can I follow you? So that I may learn some lessons from you, which you have been taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Higher knowledge, higher truth. Then, قال إنك لن تستطيع معي الصبر. Khadir alayhi salam said, إنك, certainly you, لن تستطيع معي الصبر. You will not be able to have patience with me, sober with me. You will not be able to have sober or patience with me. وكيف تصبر على ما لم تخط به خبرا. And how can you have patience about things about which you have no understanding, no knowledge, or your knowledge is not complete on such subjects. Then how can you have patience with me? Then what happened? قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أغصي لك أمرا. موسى عليه السلام said, you will find me إن شاء الله, if Allah wills, you will find me patient, nor shall I disobey you in aught. This, whenever we mention, whenever we say a thing in the future, that we will do or we will see, we will watch like that, then we have to say what? We have to say? We have to say, whenever we say about a thing, I will do that tomorrow, I will do that next month, then what should we say?
Inshallah.
Yes, inshallah. We should say inshallah. So Musa alayhi salam said, قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا. You will find me إن شاء الله. You will find me إن شاء الله patient. You will find me patient. And ولا أغصي لك أمرا. And I shall not disobey you in any matter. Then قال فإن اتبعتني فلا تسألني عن شيء حتى أحدث لك منه ذكرا. If you follow me, Khadir alayhi salam says to Musa alayhi salam, then if you follow me, what is the condition? Don't ask me questions about anything. Hatta uhdith laka min fikra, until I give myself about that concerning it, about concerning it. Until I give my own explanation for that. So condition is that fala tasalni an shay in hatta uhdith laka minhu dhikra. فانطلقا حتى إذا ركبا في السفينة خرقها قال أخرقتها لتغرق أهلها لقد جئت شيئا إمرا. So they proceeded. Khidr alayhi salam and Musa alayhi salam proceeded their travel, continued until they reached in a boat, okay, or in a safina, in a ship. Then he scuttled it, or he made a hole for that ship. Who? Khidr alayhi salam made a hole to that ship, and the ship some damage occurred. Then that ship kharaqaha. Qala, then Musa alayhi salam said, akharaqtaha litughriqa ahlaha laqad ji'ta shay'an imra. Have you damaged the ship in order to drown those who are in it, in order to drown the crew in it? Have you damaged the ship? What are you doing? Then لقد جئت شيئا امرا, truly you have done a strange thing. വിചിത്രമായ കാര്യമാണ് താങ്കൾ ചെയ്തത്. قال ألم أقل لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. Then Khidr alayhi salam replied, did I not tell you that you will have no patience with me? Okay, didn't I tell you earlier? Okay, then what did Musa say? قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت ولا ترهقني من أمري عسرا. Musa alayhi salam said, rebuke me not for forgetting, nor grieve me by rising difficulties in my case. I forgot. Please. Musa alayhi salam asked an excuse. Okay. Then فَانْطَلَقَا حَتَّى إِذَا لَقِيَا غُلَامًا فَقَتَلَهُ قَالَ أَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا زَكِيَّةً بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا نُكْرًا. Then they proceeded their journey. Who proceeded? Who continued their journey? Khidr alayhi salam and
Musa
alayhi salam. Then they proceeded until when they met a young man and he slew him. Khidr alayhi salam slew this young boy. Ulam. Qala. Then Musa alayhi salam said, أَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسٌ زَكِيَّةً بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ. Have you slain? Have you killed an innocent person who had slain none without any haq? Without any haq, you killed an innocent boy. What are you doing? Then, لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا نُكُرًا. Suddenly you have done a foul thing. Foul, a bad thing. Okay. What are you doing? Then also he asked, said, replied, Khidr replied, قال ألم أقل لك إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا. He answered, Khidr answered, did I tell you that you have no patience with me? You can't have patience with me. Did I tell you earlier? Okay, then. قال إن سألتك عن شيء بعدها فلا تصاحبني قد بلغت من لدني عذرا. So it is for the second time. Musa asked questions. Their condition was that he shouldn't ask any questions until he revealed himself the secrets to Musa alayhi salam. Okay, then Musa alayhi salam replied, إِنْ سَأَلْتُكَ عَنْ شَيْءٍ بَعْدَهَا. Now, if ever I asked you about anything after this, then فَلَا تُصَاحِبْنِي, keep me not in your company. I will leave you. You can leave me. Okay. Then قَدْ بَلَغُتَ مِنْ لَدُنِّي عُذْرًا. Then, would you will find me, receive an excuse, a full excuse. You will find full excuse. Then I will leave your company. Okay. So once more, Musa alayhi salam. Then next. فانطلق حتى إذا أتيا أهل قرية استطعما أهلها فأبوا أن يضيفهما فوجدا فيها جدارا يريد إنقل أن ينقل فأقامه قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا. Then they proceeded. They continued until when they came to the inhabitants of a town. They reached a قرية, a town or a village, and they asked them for food. استطعما, طعام means food, yes, say aloud, طعام, food. استطعما, asked for food, for sought for food. Then Musa alayhi salam and Khidr alayhi salam were traveling, both of them were traveling. They asked for some food for the to the inhabitants of that town. They asked them for food, but they refused them their hospitality. Refused them hospitality. We offered. Then فَوَجَدَا فِي هَاجِدَارٍ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَنْقَلَّ. Then they, both of them, saw a wall there, on the point of falling down, about to fall down. That wall was about to destruct, about to be destroyed or to be fall. Then what did Khidr do? فَقَامَ. Then he set it aright or set it straight. Khidr alayhi salam set this wall straight. Straight. Then so he maintained it. He maintained it. Then Musa alayhi salam said, قَالَ لَوْ شِيْتَ لَتَّخِذْتَ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا. If you do, if you had wished, surely you could have extracted, or you could have earned, or received some recompense for it, some kuli, some reward for doing this act. That is, you set straight this jidar or wall which was about to fall, and that wall was in the village where they received no liyabat, no hospitality. So why did you do so? You didn't receive any money or any ajr from them, any kuli for them, from them. You could have received some money from them. Okay. Then قال هذا فراق بيني وبينك سأنبئك بتأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا. Then Khidr alayhi salam said, what? He answered, this is the parting me, this is the parting between me and you. Who said? Khidr alayhi salam said, Ahsanti. Then this is the firaq between you and me. Firaq means departing. Firaq. وَظَنَّ أَنَّهُ الْفِرَاقُ وَاسْتَفَّتِ السَّاقُ بِالسَّاقُ. About mouth, death, process. Then سَأُنَبِّئُكَ بِتَأْوِيلِ مَا لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ عَلَيْهِ الصَّبْرًا. Now I will tell you the interpretation of those things over which you were unable to hold patience. So the things which you couldn't understand, the secrets I am going to tell you. After that we will be parting. I can't keep you your company. Okay. Then أما السفينة فكانت لمساكين يعملون في البحر فأردت أن نغيبها فكان وراءهم ملك يأخذ كل سفينة غصبا. Then as for the boat or as for the ship, what the ship's case, I made a hole or made some damage for that ship. Why? It belonged to certain men in certain poor men. They played on the water. Then, but I wished to render it unserviceable or to make it some damage. For there was after them, behind them, a certain king, a king who seized on every ship by force. So there was to come a king, a ruler, who wanted to seize all the ships, all the good ships. So when he see the damaged ship, he will get it free. He will not seize it from these poor people. So I made some little damage to that ship. So that is the secret of the first king. Then, next. فَأَمَّا الْغُلَامُ فَكَانَ أَبَوَاهُ مُؤْمِنَيْنِ فَخَشِينَ أَنْ يُرْهِقَهُمَا طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا. As for the youth, his parents were people of faith, and we feared that he should grieve them by obstinate rebellion and ingratitude to Allah. So, as for the boy, I slain or I killed that boy, because when he grew up, he will make his parents astray. There is a chance for that. Then I killed that boy. So in the Shariat, it is not allowed actually. But this thing Hazrat Ali Salam do upon the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not upon his own will. Okay. So such things we can't understand by merely looking into Shariat's hukum. Okay. Such things will be understood only by arifi. Only by arif. Arifin, that is, who have special knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then. فَأَرَدْنَا أَنْ يُبْدِلَهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا خَيْرًا مِنْهُ زَكَاةً وَأَقْرَبَ رُحْمًا. So we desired that their Lord would give them in exchange a son better in purity of conduct and closer in affection, love. Okay, then. That's why I killed that boy. Okay. وَأَمَّا الْجِدَارُ فَكَانَ لِغُلَامَيْنِ يَتِيمَيْنِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ. As for the wall, it belonged to youth, two boys, orphans. Two orphan boys, and wakana in the city, in the town, wakana tahtahu kanzullahuma, and under that wall there was a treasure for them, kept for them by their father, wakana abuhuma saliha, and their father was a salih person, a good person. فَأَرَادَ رَبُّكَ. And your Lord, Rabb, intended, that is, Allah intended, أَنْ يَبْلُغَا شُدَّهُمَا. When they reach their, when they grew up into grown-up people, into kibar, then, وَيَسْتَخْرِجَا كَنْزَهُمَا. And to extract it out for them. Then, رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ, as a blessing from your Lord. وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ أَنْ أَمْرِي. And I didn't do all these things upon my will. Then, ذَلِكَ تَأْوِيلُ مَا لَمْ تَسْتَطِعْ عَلَيْهِ صُبْرًا. Such is the interpretation of those things over which you were unable to hold patience. So, this jidar, wall, was in a land where they were not received or they were not even given some food. Still, Khadr alayhi salam made this wall or set this wall straight because there was a treasure beneath that, and if that wall was closed, someone may take that treasure, and these people or these boys will not, these orphans will not get it when they grew up. So Allah commanded him to set straight the wall. Okay, so all these things Khadr alayhi salam did upon the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not upon his own will. Okay, that's why he say ذَلِكَ تَأْوِيلُ مَا لَمْ that's why he say وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ أَنْ أَمْرِي and I did it not of my own accord or of my own will.